Hello children, welcome to the session. In this video, we are going to revise exercise 5.2 from chapter 5. What is chapter 5? Arithmetic progression, right? In that, we are going to see exercise 5.2. The complete exercise is about nth term of an AP. What is nth term of an AP? Randomly, if we pick a term from an arithmetic progression, that is from the given series, that is considered as nth term. Because we picked it randomly, we did not know the exact position of that particular term in the given series. That is nth term. Nth term is represented as an. Check the formula for an, which you know, an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. What is a? A is the first term of a series. What is d? Common difference in that particular AP. What is n? The number of terms included in the AP. A and d will take any value as positive, negative, fraction and decimal. But I told you in the previous video itself, children, that n will always take a positive value. That is a whole number. N will only take a whole number. That is, what is the second formula here? Children, what did I say to you about L in the previous video? What is L? L is the last term, right? This is also a formula for finding an only. When we will use this formula? When if the question is posted to you to find a particular term, for example a10, from the last of the series. If a finite series is given to you, what is a finite series? If the number of terms in the series is countable and if it is stopped or if it is terminates, that series is called as finite series. What is an infinite series? If we did not know how many terms are included in that particular AP and if we did not know n and if we are not able to count that AP, the number of terms in that AP is uncountable, that is infinite. Now, if a finite AP is posted to you and in the question, if they ask you to find out a10 from the last of the series, find out the fifth term from the last, find out the sixth term from the end of the AP. If they ask question like that, we'll be using this AN formula. The same I ask you to copy this formula in your content book. I told you when I was teaching this chapter, right? If you forgot to do so, now do copy this AN formula which is not in your content book. If they ask you to find out a particular term from the last, what we'll do? L minus, instead of first term, we'll go for last term. Instead of plus, we'll go for minus. That's all, then n minus 1 into d. Now let us see exercise 5.2. Only this formula is used in the complete exercise. There are three different types of sum. One is finding an from the last, one is finding an from the beginning, and one more sum is like finding the missing terms in the AP. And the last type of sum is like checking which term is the given number. For example, if 75 is given to you, you need to find the position of that 75 in the AP. These are the different sums which we are going to see in exercise 5.2. Now check question number 3 in exercise 5.2. What is question number 3? In 3, they ask us to find out the missing terms. I am solving the third subdivision now. Check that the first term is given. Second term is missing. Third term is missing. And the fourth term is given. We need to find out the missing two terms. What is the first term is represented as A. So A is given as 5. And what is the fourth term? Fourth term is represented as A4. What is the general format for A4? A plus 3. What is the value of that A4 given in the question here? 9, 1 by 2. Now substitute the value of A here. What will you get? 5 plus 3d is equal to, convert this mixed fraction into improper fraction, 19 by 2. Now we need to find out d. Transpose 5, what we will get? 19 by 2 minus 5. 3d is equal to, take LCM here, into 2 into 2. 19 minus 10 by 2. 3d is equal to 9 by 2. So what is d? D is equal to 9 by 2 into, when I bring the multiplicate number which is in multiplication
with the variable to the other side of the equation. That is, when I'm transposing a number which is in product with that particular variable to the other side of the equation, that multiplication will become division. If I cancel, what I'll get? D is equal to 3/2. We found D is equal to 3/2. After that, substitute the value of D in the equation. A plus 3D is equal to 9 1/2. A4 value is 9 1/2, right? A4 is written as A plus 3D, right? Here substitute the value of D, you will get the value of A. A plus 3 into 3/2 is equal to 19/2. So A is equal to 19/2 minus 9/2. So what is A? A is equal to 10/2, which is equal to 5. This is what given in the question itself. The first term is given in the question itself, right? What we want to find here? We need to find out the missing term. What is the missing term? A2. A2 is written as A plus D. That is equal to 5 plus 3/2. When we take LCM, what we will get? 5 into 2, 10 plus 3/2. Therefore, A2 is equal to 13/2. We found the first missing term A2 as 13/2. The second missing term, that is A3. The second missing term is A3, which can be written as A plus 2D. A is 5 given in the question itself. D we found as 3/2. So 2 will get cancelled. 5 plus 3, it is 8. A3 value we got as 8. What is this sum, children? Two terms of the AB is given. The other two terms are missing. They are just to find out. We found the second term as 13/2 and the third term as 8. Next, we will be solving question number 9. Take your content book page number 106 and see the question. If the third and the ninth term of the AB are 4 and minus 8, there is an AB whose third and ninth term is given. Which term of this AP is 0? We need to find out the position of the number 0 in this AP. This AP consists of positive numbers as well as negative numbers. So there is a chance that 0 will also lie between these two numbers. 0 will not be the first or second term, and 0 will not be the 10th or the 11th term. It should be a number which joins the positive and the negative number, right? So 0, there is a chance that 0 may be a number, a term between 3 and 9. Now let us see how to solve this sum. A plus 2D, that is equal to 4. A3 general format is A plus 2D, right? And that value in the question is given as 4. And then what else is given? A9, which is equal to A plus 8D is equal to minus 8. Now, linear equation in two variables, find the difference. So, minus here and plus here, this will get cancelled. Minus 6D is equal to 12. So, what is the value of D? Minus 2. We found the value of D as minus 2. Let us find out the value of A. Substitute the value of D in equation 1. What we will get? A plus 2 into minus 2 is equal to 4. So A is equal to 4. Transpose 2 into minus 2 to the other side. Minus 4, when you are transposing to the other side, you will get plus 4. So the value of A is equal to 8. What we have found here? We got the value of A and D. A is 8 and D is minus 2. What do you want to find out actually? You need to find out the position of the number 0 in this particular AB. So I am considering that there is a position for the number 0 in the AB, and that position is AN. 0 is the nth term of the AB I considered. Now substitute the value for formula for AN. AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D, right? What is the value of A we got here? 8. What is the value of N? That is what we want to find out. And what is the value of D we got here? Minus 2. 0 is equal to 8 plus N minus 1 into minus 2. Bring 8 to the other side of your equation. Plus 8 becomes minus 8. And what do you have in the next equation? N minus 1 into
minus 2. Bring minus. When we transpose minus 2 also to the other hand side, I'll get minus 8 by minus 2 is equal to n minus 1. So 4 is equal to n minus 1. N is equal to 4 plus 1. N is equal to 5. We got n is equal to 5. What does it mean? The position of 0 in this AP is 5. It means that the fifth term of this AP is 0. What sum is this, children? Two terms of an AP is given and they are asking us to check whether 0 is also a term of that AP. If so, what is the position of 0? What we did for the two terms, we written linear equation, solved for A and B, and then we considered 0 as the nth term of the AP, and then we found out the value of n. So that we solved the sum and found that 0 is the fifth term of this AP. This is the second method of sum. In 5.2, three different methods are there, I told you. If they will be giving a number and they will be asking us to find out which term is that number in the AP. If there is missing terms in an AP, that we need to find out. That is the second method. And the third method is finding AN from the last. Now check question number 17 in your content book. See, in question number 17, it is given that last term is 253. See the series, the last term is 253. We need to find out AN from the last, the 20th term. We need to find out the 20th term from the last of the series. And D, the common difference of the series is 3. We have learnt another formula for finding AN if they asked us to find out a term from the last, right? What is that formula? L minus N minus 1 into D. What is L? 253. What is N? N is 20. 20 minus 1. And what is D? D is 3. Now we need to find this. 20 minus 1 into 3. We need to find out that AN, right? Calculate 253 minus 19 into 3. 19 into 3 is... Children, check, there is a change. In the question, it is given that the common difference is equal to 5. So I changed. Here also the common difference 5, here also 5. 19 into 5. What is the product of 19 and 5? That is 95. When you get the difference of 253 and 95, it is 158. What is 158? A20 is 158. In the given series, if I find the 20th term from the last, I got that term as 158. What is the last term? The last term is 253. And 20th term from the last is 158. Check, children, the formula again, a very important formula. AN is equal to L minus N minus 1 into D. That's all exercise 5.2 is about. So what are the different sums we can expect from 5.2? One is series will be given and few terms will be missing. We need to find out the missing terms using the formula AN. And secondly, a number will be given and they will be asking us to find the position of that number in the given AP. Which term is that number in the given AP? And third sum is finding AN from the beginning. Simply, they will ask us to find out what is the second term, which is the 20th term. Fourth and the last method is like, we need to find out a term from the last, from the end of an AP. For that, there is a different formula for AN. That's all. Exercise 5.2 is over. Go through all the sums in this video. This video I have made to make you understand that only these are the concepts in exercise 5.2. To get to know detail about this exercise, kindly go through the video which I made when I'm teaching this chapter. Thank you.